Did you know that we used to swing from tree to tree? That we were covered in fur and had a tail? It might seem hard to believe today, but if you look closely, you can find remnants of our animal ancestors all over your body.
What?
These anatomical quirks may have served our ancestral lineage a few million years ago, but they're utterly useless to the modern human. What idle body parts are you still clinging to? And why are they still here? This is Your Body On, Stuff Your Body No Longer Needs. Number 5, the Plica semilunaris. In the corner of your eye, you can spot a small pink tissue. This little guy is the leftover of a third eyelid our early animal ancestors had that blinked horizontally. Prehistoric creatures like birds and reptiles still have this third eyelid, which provides them additional protection from debris. The nictitating membrane might be useless, but it's also totally harmless. So I recommend you leave it alone.
My eyes!
Number 4, the Palmaris longus. Back when we used to swing from tree to tree, this wrist muscle provided additional support for gripping branches. It became useless 3.2 million years ago, when we dropped from the treetops to start walking on 2 feet.
Hey, who wants to see me climb a tree?
Despite this, about 86% of modern humans still have the palmaris longus. Are you one of them? Put your pinky and thumb together. If you see a long, tendon-like structure sticking up in your arm, you're part of the majority.
Special.
But don't get any crazy ideas. Today, the presence of the palmaris longus has no bearing on a person's grip strength.
Parkour!
Number 3, Darwin's tubercle. Do you have a small bump on your outer ear?
Yes.
That point is Darwin's tubercle.
Fascinating.
It allowed early humans to move their ears in the direction of sounds, but it's been rendered useless through evolution. Although we can no longer move our ear muscles, that ability has not been lost in other animals. Aww. In our modern age, only 10% of the global population still have ears featuring this bump.
Well, I'll take one.
And be careful, because this trait can be used to identify you in court through forensic science. So if you're planning on cooking up some mischief, you might want to think about getting it removed. But shh, you didn't hear that from me.
I like the shape of your ears.
Number 2, goosebumps. Do you get goosebumps when you're scared? Well, they won't keep you safe today, but they did protect our ancestors. Goosebumps are the result of small muscles in the skin flexing and raising the surrounding hair. This made our furry forebears appear bigger and intimidating when threatened. Today, goosebumps have little effect on our relatively hairless bodies.
Take your pants off!
And they certainly won't scare away predators. Seriously, those little bumps? Not threatening. Run! Number 1, the coccyx. Back in our tree swinging days, early humans had a tail to help them keep balanced. But when we became bipedal, this tail shrank smaller and smaller until all that was left was the coccyx.
My tail! Where's my tail?
But the tail is not completely lost in the modern human. During embryonic development, a tail will start to develop at 4 to 6 weeks, but dissolves soon after. And if it doesn't, the tail can easily be removed through surgery.
Where's my tail?
Although the tailbone is a vestigial trait, it has taken on a modern role as an anchor for the muscles holding the anus in place. It would be a pain in the butt if that fell off.
I love butt stuff.
Today, this extra stuff is no more than a reminder of our ancestral roots, but what might our future descendants look like? Well, current research suggests that as our medical care and nutrition improve, people are expected to grow taller over time. Some scientists predict that with one-third of the population selecting partners through the vanity of dating apps, future generations are likely to be more attractive. Lucky them.
Don't be jealous.
If you're trying to attract a mate, maybe try squatting for 24 hours. We'll see what that would do to you on another episode of Your Body On.